Previously on Craft and Burn.
Ma'am, drop the bat.
Several of my colleagues at the FBI have just spent the past 3 hours dismantling what appear to be over 300 plastic grenades filled with glitter and traces of hair from what we believe is a Mongolian subspecies of cheetah that hasn't been seen since the 9th century. So someone is going to have to explain to me what the f*** is going on here.
Well, if your friends at the FBI can't do that for you, then I don't know what the f*** it is they do all day.
Well, for one thing, they found your boyfriend's little Michael Jackson bike club headquarters, huh? Yeah? Yeah? Okay? Oh, yeah. Where is he?
He's probably at the getaway craft.
What did you say?
I said he's probably at the aquarium.
Well, we're really going to need to ask him some questions about all of this.
Well, any questions you have for him, you can ask me.
All right, let's start with what in David Bowie's name are you wearing?
Excuse me?
Next question. This little glitter renovation project accomplishes what exactly?
Okay, first of all, I'd appreciate it if you treated us with some respect and used the word revolution. This isn't a renovation, okay? We're not building a fucking family room. We're initiating a fucking renaissance.
No, 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 you're not.
All right, you want to break this down for you? Is that what you want?
I'd appreciate it.
Your police cars. They make a loud sound, but they do not simultaneously release confetti and streamers. Why?
What the hell did you just say?
Please save all of your questions until the end of the manifesto, please. Why is every paper napkin not an individual specialized collage of some sort? Why is the internet not just a massive elaborate scrapbook that is kept in the town square for everyone to reference? The answer is because the world is crafting negative. And those of us who are crafting positive are mad as hell, and we're not gonna take it anymore.
Is it over?
Oh, it's over for you.
So, do I understand correctly that you believe that glitter and primitive cheetah hair are gonna turn the internet into a scrapbook?
Okay, well, you're just intentionally phrasing that so that it sounds crazy.
How am I gonna get my email?
You're gonna look in your section.
So everybody's gonna have a section.
Yeah, I mean, yes, everyone has a section.
Uh-huh. And say me and 10 million other people want to get our email at the same time.
Well, there's clearly a line. Everyone has to wait in line.
It's like a long-ass line.
Well, while you wait, you can make some paper napkin collages. Yeah, that's what I forgot. That's the new labor force. The new labor force is all of the people waiting in the town square. Okay, I see what you're critiquing here, but it's really complicated.
No, it's not complicated. It's just a terrible idea. You've got mail. I'd read it.
Hey, Kim. It's Ethan. Sorry to sort of disappear on you. Headed to the getaway craft island earlier than you might have anticipated previously, but that's fine. Just trying to figure out how to craft, like, food and, you know, supplies and stuff I need to live. But I will be in touch shortly, and I hope hugs and kisses.
All right. I think it's time that I broke some things down for you, all right? A. This crafting food and other living supplies will not work out, okay? B, I don't care if you're talking about glitter or you're talking about uranium. You start throwing around four-figure sums in cash. You start Googling blueprints for the UN. You start talking about defacing international property. You better believe you become a person of interest to a whole lot of people, a whole lot scarier than me. Which brings us to C. We will find him. Whether he's alive or not by the time we get to him.
Maybe I'll tell you where he is.
Maybe.
Is he really a person of interest?
So to speak.
Well, then what's he worth to you?
What do you want?
I want $5,000.
can be arranged.
Welcome back.
Thank you. I'm sorry that... I'm sorry I wasn't here.
It's okay. I'm glad you're here now. How are you feeling?
I'm very... I mean, I've been trying to do all the things that you talk about, you know. I've been trying to get some perspective and you know, take a step back and check in with myself and all that stuff, and maybe we went about everything the wrong way, but he was right. I do want the world to look like that, and I always have, and I think I always will, and I hate feeling bad about that, and I just have a really hard time thinking that there's something inherently wrong with wanting that.
There's nothing wrong with that. Of course there's nothing wrong with that. It comes from a really beautiful, generous place, I think. Where Kim runs into trouble is when that impulse overwhelms respect for other people's space or property. But there were a lot of things that were wonderful about Ethan and what you guys had together. We don't want to take crafting from you, but we want you to be able to come to it from a strong place.
Right.
Recovery is not a short road, you know, and it's going to be disorienting.
I feel very disoriented.
You are not alone. We're going to figure it out. And crafting is going to become even better for you, because you're going to come at it from a different place.
I like this that you're talking about now, about crafting getting better. I'm feeling very positively about that.
Right. Maybe the next step might be crafting with a moderate amount of supervision or other constraints. And if you need help finding opportunities like that, I am more than happy to do research and help you in whatever way I can.
Kim, hi.
Hi.
Come in, have a seat. Wow, your dress.
Yes, it's my craft dress.
It's fascinating.
Thank you.
Well, welcome. We have your application for the Genius Grant,
mm-hmm.
and I'd love to hear now, in your own words, what would you do if you won the Ethel Eichenberger Genius Foundation Grant?
I'm interested in covering buildings in glitter, legally.
Wow.
So how are you feeling today?
I am feeling great.
Really?
Yeah. Because it turns out... I'm a genius. This is a letter telling me I'm a genius.
That's right.
That's genius right here. This guy. I'm very pleased with myself.
I can tell.
And there's a budget. There's a budget put in place for this.
You know how I feel about budgets.
I know how much you love budgets.
Love them.
They have to pick the buildings, I think, though. We have to discuss their ideas for what buildings.
Well, the buildings probably have to...
agree to it?
Yeah.
Maybe.
The people who own the buildings. Not the buildings themselves.
Sure. I guess I'm more interested in buildings that, like, aren't really owned by anybody.
Other buildings?
Like, who...
of that nature?
Who owns, technically speaking, like, who owns the White House? I do.
Well.
My taxes, I mean, I haven't paid taxes in, but theoretically, were I to actually pay taxes, they suggested the Tenement Museum. And I was like, I think that's kind of counterproductive to the idea of the Tenement Museum. I feel like the Tenement Museum wants to look like a tenement. I won. I never win anything. I mean, I got picked for, like, jury duty, but that's not really winning.
No.
That's losing.
Mm. Is that you?
I'm a genius.
No.
No, no, that's not me. That's Ethel Eichenberger. Let's get real here.
Well, it's a civic duty. It's a civic duty.
Well, whatever. My civic duties now... My civic duty is to be a genius. Guess who made this owl vest?
a genius. This is the work of a genius.